like I said, to be honest, most of the teams they face off against were minnows, so to speak, in the Asian scene. So there's not much you can really look into that. So I'm just waiting to see who's going to come on top. Mongols, Mapic, Dust 2, as we're going straight into the knife round. And, well, it's going to be Eureka starting things off here on the right foot, getting a few shanks in, but Mongols replying by Watsugu, last man left alive, and it's going to be Eureka winning the knife round pretty comfortably. And we're going to immediately go live here very, very soon. Eureka just taking a quick pause to decide where they're going to be starting on. I'm assuming that they might just start on the CD, on the T side. Mongols being a team who would definitely prefer starting on a T side. And alright, this is interesting. Rekka starting on the CT side, which is curious. Usually against Mongols, you would like to start on the T side, because their CT side is a little bit more suspect. But if you allow or give a window of opportunity for Mongols to start stringing a few rounds on the T side, they can kind of go out of control. They can just go for a 12-3 or even a 13-2 half scoreline. And it is Mongols' map pick. It is Dust 2, where they can really leverage the aim, that aggression that they're famed for. And you can see Rozzy pushing towards pit. He's alone there. He does have backup in the form of Bented, but Bented's all the way back towards Carr. He's slowly making his way towards Long, though. It's going to be a long play coming out real quickly. Bented was crosshair trained towards Long double doors and Mongols. Flashbang comes out. Bented's not going to be blinded, though. The nade won't do much damage. And immediately Bented and Rozzy, they're both so very low. The Flashbang comes out, though. Rozzy needs to make this count. He's tapping away, unable to get the kill. And Cabal and Mara are going to team up together to get two quick kills. Sisters reply by finding Mara. It's a 3v4 here. And Sugu spots out Frost Misty, going with the Glock here, and does get taken down. Sis, meanwhile, with two more huge kills, leaving it all down to Dobu, and Dobu gets a kill on Frost Misty, and Sis is on 24 HP. Dobu unable to clutch it out. Sis with the quad kill, that is absolutely huge. Survives on 10 HP, and Rekka Esports win the pistol round. Sis going absolutely ham there, and the Mongols. Well, that really should have been the Mongols' round. They had a great entry, immediately tagging Bented and Rozzy over in pit and long. And then Sis just steps up with four crazy kills. And Rekka Esports, they managed to take the pistol round. You can see immediately rifles coming out on Sis and Rozzy. And the UMPs on Bented and Sis and Frost Misty. And fast B play Mima coming out. And Sis should be careful. He's got the M4. He's got the sole M4 in the team. And for Mongols, it's Tech9's armor. Sis playing it smart. He gets a kill on NCL. And the bomb will get planted for the Mongols. Now, this is going to be tricky. The Tech9s are deadly indeed. And Rozzy's going to come charging in alone. But the UMP, a little bit too much for Mara to handle. Now it's a 3v5 post-plant. As Frost Misty is going to get taken up on X-Curve with the scout. Gets the kill. Cabal all alone. And he's going to tap through the flashbang. Gets a kill, but won't get any more. As Bented will drop him. And Rekka should be able to salvage an M4 as well. From Sis, and that's gonna be 2-0 to Rekka. Mongols should be pretty happy with that. They got the bomb down, they got two kills as well. And Rekka upgrading the M4 and Bented, while Xcurt's still gonna be wielding the scout. And I'm assuming he's and Mongols with an interesting buy there. Sogu with the AK. The rest of them, Deagle and NCL, armor P250 on Cabal. That's curious indeed. I would expect that go for full eco. Xcrit spots on the shoulder, goes for a shot, but Cabal, perfect timing, peeks out, catches Xcrit off guard, gets a headshot, and that's a man down early on. But this aggression from Frost Misty, he spots out Dobu, doesn't really want to take the fight. And Mongols an early man advantage, but Rozzy pushed in pretty deep over the long door. So if he gets a flank right, he could just completely decimate this play. He can catch those two players of Mongols over at mid. But NCL is marking the back. They have their angles covered, and Mongols are gearing up for this B play. Rozzy is deep, spotted by Sugu, taking a bit of damage. And Mongols, no, they're falling back now. They're falling from tunnels. Probably heading for the B play. They have no smoke, though. They want to fake out mid to B. The nade's going to come in. That's a bit of damage to Sugu. And Bented's all alone. This is a very smart call for Mongols. If they push in, and there comes the push. Benta, though, gets taken out. Tsugu with its sole AK-47 on the T side. He finds a kill. Meanwhile, another play has been dropped. Sis does reply back, though. He finds NCL. He could find Tsugu as well, but he's getting shot from all directions. Cabal's gonna find Frost Misty, and all of a sudden, Mongols off the back of one AK buying a few pistols. They pull off the round, and Rekka will be forced to go for the eco here. How did that even happen? Mongols just picking Rekka one by one by one, and then one soul. They just needed to get Bented over in the A bomb site, and that AK-47 to ripping his head clean off. Rekka with the upgrade pistols for Mongols, though, it's going to be a full buy. Rifles all around. They're not going to bother wasting their time with SMGs. Dobu solely lurking towards the lower tunnel. Rekka playing with a stack over at mid. They got three guys now, four guys over near CD spawn, and Excurate right behind the door with a PD50 of his. They have sent in a man towards the B bomb site now. There's a Frost Misty, nice flashbang, but Mongols aren't going to take advantage of that. Dobu just holding the line, doesn't need to peek out, doesn't need to really go for the fight. They have the utility, they have lots of utility. Three Molotovs still to work with. The mid to be smoke comes out, but they're not going to be committing to this, as Cabal's going to find Frost Misty over the B bomb side, the back of B platform, as Dobu's going to find Exit as well, who's trying to be sneaky, trying to push into mid. And now the B bomb side almost compromised, but Mongols, they're still a little paranoid. And Sis, he's going to peek around the corner, and Cabal's there to rip his head clean off. It's going to be all down to Benton and Rozzy. Not much of a chance to pull this round off, and this should be round number two for Mongols, tying things up. And there we go, Dobu and Tsugu to pick up the final two kills. Flawless round for Mongols, and they need that. They had five rifles at the open Maro as well, not losing a single gun, and that's going to do wonders for their economy. Rekka, though, they're going to buy up little bit of a light buy. Two M4s, two UMPs. The op on Excurate, and it's a glass cannon, and he's going to be duking it out against Mara, which is curious. I would have thought, you know, in the absence of the Zilkenberg machine, that it would be Dobu who would be doing the opping, but yeah, these are the Mongols. Almost all of them can op and rifle. That's Rekka. Okay, alright. Alright, I have no idea what this is. Production? What was that? Okay. Alright. I have no idea what just happened there. Well, at least it didn't switch to a basketball montage like what happened in E-League, so I guess we got that going for us. Extrude with the op, and the smoke's gonna block him off. The flashbang comes in. This is a risky angle for him. He's so close to the door with the op. He doesn't have any armor either. And he does have his teammate nearby to back him up if push does come out. But it's very risky. He can get almost insta-headshotted considering the Mongols. And Mongols taking very... So this is very uncharacteristic of the Mongols. Slowing it down so much. And again, Rozzy is pushed in pretty deep towards long doors. You can hear Tsugu running around. I don't think Tsugu knows where Rozzy is playing from. The Molotov's tossed in pretty deep. And he's making a lot of noise. He's running all the way. And Rozzy, is he going to make the play? Yes, he is flanking in right now. Sis, he's going to need backup real quickly. And Rozzy, if he makes haste here, he can just shut this down. The nade's going to come in perfectly. Frostmist is going to find Mara in the meantime. And the Mongols, they're kind of caught out here. They're going for the mid play, but Benton is there with his UMP. Shuts two of them down. And Mongols, Dobu, and NCL remaining in his 2v4. And Dobu, 20 seconds. They need to make a play here. And Dobu doesn't manage to get the kill. He does find Benton in the meantime, but a bomb is down. 14 seconds on the clock. Dobu doesn't have a chance in hell here. He's going to just try to hold on to his AK-47 as Excurate is going to get the kill on the C4 carrier, and that is going to be round number three for Rekka, making it work in the second buy round. For the Mongols, shouldn't be too worried. They should be able to buy back in. They had all guys staying alive the previous round. And let's see if the legends are true. Let's see if Bented and Excurate go ham. Right now it's been Sis, though. They say he hit that 4k he got in pistol round, just saved them. Still early days, 3-2, Rekka with a double op setup. Alright then, Bented and Excurate against 5 AK-47s. Mongols, though, just because, like I said, they had a very good anti-eco run, will be having 5 AKs lot of utility to work with as well. And all of them playing from top mid. And Razu trying to use that wall of smoke. He has no idea where Mongols are at the moment. He's made his way towards pit as the Mongols creeping up towards cat. But I don't know if they're going to be aware of this dual op setup there. It might be expecting X-Ray to be playing from mid or from the B bomb site. And now they're going to be facing off against Sis and Bented. Bented with the op. Train towards. Oh, flashbang comes out. Bented gets it first. Looking for more. Misses the second kill. And Dobu's going to reply back. Two quick headshots back to back. And all of a sudden, Mongols with a man advantage. And they have made a way into the bomb site as well. There's still a guy over in long. That's Razu, who hasn't shown his hand yet. Rekka. We'll be going for the retake. Sogo, he's got backup. But X-Root taps away, but X-Root's going to get the kill. Now it's a 3v3. Frost Misty making his way from long. And NCL, he has the AK. He can't pick up the AWP from Bented. And ooh, the Molotov's going to push him back. The perfect Molotov. X-Root's going to find a kill on the Dobu as well. All of a sudden, it's down to NCL. He's going to go ham here. Goes for the spray, but Rozzy's going to get the kill. And that was a clean retake from Rekka. 3v4, no problem. And they get the defuse comfortably as well. And that is going to be round number 4 for Rekka Esports. Mongols do get the bomb down, but the money is still going to be pretty crap. Dobu on 6k should be able to... Actually, they're going to force it up. Yeah, of course they're going to force it up. Two guys with 6k, and they're going to get the op as well. Barely any utility. NCL should be able to buy a lot of utility, though. This guy, he still hasn't bought up the armor and the nade, so... Mongols... Get yet another buy, although three smokes, a handful of flashes, a Molotov, and a nade. Not the best utility to work with, but yeah, it's the Mongols. Excurate. Flashbang comes out. He's still holding the line, blinded or not. That is so ballsy from him, and it's going to decapitate. Dobu just walks in straight into his crosshair. And X-Ray just floating around the map like Muhammad Ali right now. Got the op though. Next crit, he's feeling a little ballsy right now. Flashbang comes out and doesn't need to over peek. They got the man advantage, just need to play a little bit more slowly. Razu with the nade, not gonna do much damage, not gonna do any damage in fact on the Sogu. And Razu, the designated long player, he's doing pretty good work. Even if he doesn't get any kills, this is ensuring that his teammates don't have to worry about long, that he has control of it, even in case of a late lurk or whatnot. X-Crit, meanwhile, with the op, finds another kill. Cabal's gonna drop. And Mara, he's gotta make this op work. This was an expensive investment from Mongols. And X-Crit with another frag. He's just picking them apart one by one by one. NCL finally does find Frost Misty, and he's immediately gotta make his way towards the B bomb site. So we have a pause getting called out. Sogu with the AK finds Bented, looking for more, gets another kill, but X-Crit with the quad kill, and now it's a lone man remaining, NCL and X-Crit. He's probably on an ace here. Spots out the man and the ace for X-Curate as we have a pause getting called. And X-Curate showing what he can do with the big green. We have a disconnect coming in for Rekka, but 5-2 to Rekka Esports. And wow, what a round for X-Curate. And I think we have some technical issues being faced by Rekka at the moment. Shouldn't take long. Mongols, third round loss bonus. They've lost 3 rounds in a row now, and they'll have about 2,400 bonus money. The rest of them, but 3,400 NCL, Sugun 4,900. They should probably just go for the pistol buys. Could probably afford some armor as well. A little bit of Kevlar, a little bit of a couple of flashes, a couple of nades. And they should be able to at least try and pressure maybe the B bomb side. Try to go for a fast play, maybe out from mid to B, and try to at least get the bomb done for the extra bonus money for the next round. So there we go. You got the players joining back in. So didn't take that long. And yeah, everyone said we should be having a restore coming in. So X-Curate though with the ace, that was nasty. That was nasty. And he was all over the map. He just peeked into lower tunnels, ballsy play from him, got the kill onto Dobu, and then picked off the guy pushing mid, shut everything down, got a third kill. He just shut mid down single-handedly, didn't need any help. And some nice clean frags. He didn't have to go for any fancy stuff, just great positioning. Great solid AWPing all around. And I gotta say, I'll be very honest. I would not have... It's still early. It's still 5-2. But right, but a couple of rounds, a few rounds I want to just take a look at, right? This round, the one where Xrid got the ace, number one. Number two, the retake when he got a 3v4. If this was the old NXL, I don't see them winning those two rounds. I really wouldn't have seen them winning those rounds. I've seen... this just seems like a very different team, which is very strange, because four of his players have played in NXL. And it's very strange, but they're not at all playing the NXL. It's a much more free-flowing, more aggressive style. They're more unleashed. And I think that's what has been missing with Islander for such a long time. Mongols, of course, going to go for the buy. Xrid, he is not stopping anytime soon. Avoids a flashbang as well. Looking for more, goes for another pick. This guy just not stopping right now. This absolute madman. Spots out a third guy, misses this one. Kabal's going to... get the killer, Rosu. He's just not stopping. He is just not stopping. 29 HP. Finally, better sense will prevail, and he will fall back. And Dobu is going to get the kill on the Bent at 3v3 now, and Sis there to reply back, leaving it down to Enseal and Kabal. And Kabal has the AK, no armor though. He should be dropping this gun to his teammate. So, bit of damage being dealt out from, like I said, pretty much an eco round. It just had the AK buy on Kabal, I think, yeah, because he had about $5,000, but the rest of them just with Tech 9s, a little bit of armor. So, whatever damage they inflict right now, they'd be pretty happy with. Three v two. Flashbang comes out. Sis alone in the site. He needs to get his kill on Kabal, and he gets taken down. Kabal, what a nasty shot! But a bomb is down. 16 seconds on the clock. Not much you can do here. Xrid just holding the line. He misses the shot, and Kabal. Oh, almost clutches it. Is he doing here? With a nasty shot and bent it. This could have been very, very close. This would have been horrendous. If Rekka lost that round, coming down to 1v1, but they will survive. But just because they're losing so many members against eco rounds, you can look at the money for Rekka, it's still very low. They have the weaponry, they have the utility for this round, but if they lose, they're going to get reset immediately, and that's a scary thought. Mongols, the full buy comes out. Kabal with the op, pre-firing on the corner, the flashbang comes in, and he times it off by a fraction of a second. I think just went between the legs there. Spots out Dobu. Both of them just ticking each other with their respective rifles. Bentet is holding the line. Mongols playing very slow. Meanwhile, over in long, we have Sogu trying to be sneaky, but Rose is hugging the doors, waiting with that UMP. This little panorama, but they execute it again. This guy's aggression and just absolutely unbridled, just insane amount of aggression, which, as fun as it is, I hope he doesn't over-aggress and gets punished for it. Kabal, rattling off a few shots. That's Kabal. Taking advantage, and Rossi's going to get the kill on Sogu. Sogu trying to push in towards towards long, and ooh, the timing, Xrid, he's been caught out here. Kabal's going to get the kill. Nasty shot on Xrid, and you can see the immediate rotation coming in from the teaser, making the way towards lower tunnels. They won't be expecting this, though, and Frost Misty with a perfect flank. He gets both the kills. The bomb is dropped as well, and that's pretty much a round for Rekka. Mongols, Kabal left alone in the 1v4, and he's got to get the ace to clutch this one out. 6 seconds, no time remaining. He should just be holding onto his AK here and not dying after the timer runs out. And that's going to be Rekka winning another round. Frost Misty with a perfect, an absolutely perfect flank there. and Mongols just. Absolutely brilliant stuff from Frostmister. And Rekka, 7-2. Takpaw is going to call the Mongols because right now they're going to be a slight little worried. You can see Cabal immediately buying up the plague of Asian Counter-Strike. I don't know how many half-buys we've seen in the past 9 rounds we've seen so far. I mean, just one eco, one full eco. And then you can go for whatever full buy you want. You can go for the double ops. It's Dust 2. You can make it work. You can go for AKs and Molotovs and everything else you want. I just don't understand why you just keep going for these half buys or, you know, kind of semi-4C buys all the time. And that's something we noticed with even the best Asian team right now, even with Tai Lu. They tend to do that. And, of course, the Mongols, it is an affliction, at least in my opinion. I just hope they don't force it up. I just hope. Oh, they're gonna force it up. They're gonna force it up. They have the AK saved, which I guess it kind of makes sense in a certain way because, I mean, he obviously doesn't have any extra money. He's just $300 because he saved the gun. But the rest of them, I mean, it's still not that late, you know. Even if they get like. Lose, you know, even if they get like 5 rounds on the T side, it's the Mongols. We've seen what they can do on the CD side. Instead, another force coming up, and you can clearly see with this force, they have no utility. They have 2 smokes, 3 flashes, and a Molotov. So it's either going to be Sukubliat Rush B or Rush Mid or something, because they don't have the utility to work with. And if that's the case, these 2 ops, an Excrete and Bente, they're going to just shred them to pieces, especially Excrete is not missing anything by the looks of things at the moment. What is this guy made of? And he gets finally taken down. Look at this aggression from NXL, but they get punished for it. Dobu's gonna fight. This is a complete slugfest. This is a street fight. And I have never seen these players, these Indonesian players, ever play like this. They're a completely different team compared to what they were with Forged. This is just balls out aggression. Dobu, last man standing. Sis, should be careful. Double. Oh, nasty headshot. It picks up the triple now. And he's going to go for the long plant here. Will he make his escape in time is the question. And Dobu with the clutch. This guy is an absolute freaking beast. The quad kill, the 1v2. Just monstrous play from Dobu. Somehow making the force buy work. And, well... Rekka. I like the aggression, I won't lie. I really like the aggression. But yeah, Dobu just doing Dobu things. There's nothing much else to add to that. Rekka going for the eco, just a few upgraded pistols coming out. 5.7s, P250s, a couple of CZs as well. Should have possibly gone for the 2v1 in the end there instead of peeking. Instead of the guy over in short peeking alone. But again, it's all in hindsight. Bented with the CZ. Over in mid. Pushing is the question. Oh, he's going to push it. Oh, picks up the UAP as well. He's going to get another kill. Almost gets the kill. And X-Crew is going to push out of doors. That's such a smart play from X-Crew. That is so very smart. Pushes out. Gets the kill. Spots the second guy. The third guy as well. I'm sorry. Mara will take him down. The aim punch being a little bit too much of a bitch to handle. And Sis is going to be the lone man standing. Dobu. Racking up the final 2 kills. 7-4 for the Mongols. And the Rekka. Immediately going for the buy. They do have the money. However, they don't have the op on any one of these players. That could be a problem. The op especially has been what's been getting them a number of picks every single round they've won. So no op for Excurate, no op for Bented. Just the rifles. Couple of FAMASes in the mix as well. And Mongols, let's see how they fare here. 3 guys over at long waiting for this play. Flashbang comes out. Zergu. Smoked off, but he still gets a kill on assist. Meanwhile, Cabal's pushing towards the blue door. And does Rozzy know this by the looks of it? I don't think he does. I really don't think he does. And Cabal, he just needs to hold, just stay put there while his teammates rotate all the way over to short. But Frost Misty again over at CD spawn. There's no one in short, no short control this time coming out from Rekka. Man, that's made his way towards blue. So yeah, they're just going to be playing for long. They have a guy in the side that's going to be executed. He's got just a FAMAS though. No utility whatsoever. Doesn't have a flashbang, Molotov smoke, nothing. As Cabal's going to find Roz. He won't be expecting Benton waiting around the corner. Almost whiffs the spray. But he does make up for it. And Mongols with a perfect call. They're going to find themselves in an empty B bomb site. And Frost Misty does... Oh, a little too late there. But he does spot out the guy in the B bomb site. And Rekka... should be going for the save unless they get a kill in the next few seconds. NCL's Shadow getting spotted by Bentet. They have a nade and a flash. They have kits. But yeah, they should be just going for the save at this juncture. NCL with the scout. And that's going to be 5 rounds for Mongols. Rekka do save the 3 rifles. And they should be able to buy back again to the next round. Should be able to drop a couple of guns. And they upgrade the M4s to the AKs as well, so... The FAMASs, I'm sorry, to the AKs as well, so... And Mongols not really going for the hunt. Still got 3 more rounds remaining. Need to make sure the economy doesn't get destroyed as we reach the final round. For Rekka, though, rifles. The scout inaccurate. Scout with a scout here. Kind of, you know... Kind of weak wise considering how late we are in the first half. The Mongols. Go for the fast B is the question. They got 3 guys making their way. They got pretty good spawns. And execute with the scout over in mid. Just one guy. Oh, spots out the guy. Ralt of a shot. And he won't land anything. However, Frost Misty. Playing right next to the entrance to B tunnels. And he's all alone. They go for this B play where 3 guys are waiting. 3 guys just holding on upper dock. And he's all alone. He's been completely isolated. The smoke pushing back X-Root as well. So, Cabal, he's doing a good job making a lot of noise over in short. And that's ensuring that all 3 guys for the CTs remain there. Frost Misty. Flashbang comes out. But he's not going to spot anyone. It might give him a false sense of safety. As Cabal perfectly avoiding the flashbang. He's all the way over in Gandalf. Beautiful shot and assist, but he gets taken down. And it's going to be the B play coming out. Frost Misty spots a man out. He needs to get at least a couple of kills, or else he's going to get completely swamped. And Mara's going to get the kill. Frost Misty's down. 3v4 once more. The smokes have been deployed, but Mara gets tagged down by X-Curate through the smoke. Oh, goes for a jumping shot as well. Dobu gets spotted out. Is he going to get the kill? No, he won't. Nate's going to make his life a little bit more miserable. But I don't think he knows how much damage he's inflicted on Mara. So, this retake. They're having second thoughts. And Nade's going to come in. Dobu is going to take absolutely no damage whatsoever. Strange. Mara on the hunt. 10 HP or not. He doesn't really care. And Rekka with yet another save. But 76 for the Mongols. Still too early to call anything here. 7 rounds on board for Rekka. Is still very impressive. Like I said earlier, this is not a scoreline I would have expected from NXL, the old NXL lineup. And that says something about this particular team. Okay, I'm screwed here. How did he even hit that shot? Unless he heard him run and jump. In which case, I really need those headsets. Dobu, meanwhile. Making a lot of noise at B. And this time we can see the switch up on Rekka when it comes to the set. We just have one guy over in... just marking towards long over at barrels. That's Rosu. And they have a lot of aggression. Ooh, the team flash though. And Mara's going to get the kill. The next three. They have 2 guys holding, looking towards long doors. Benta does reply back. He does find Sogu. And he's going to fall back. Meanwhile, Sis down 24 HP. Really shouldn't be taking the fight right now. The 4v4. The Mongols have... They've been really favoring his B bombs at his late B executes, but they can still go for this because Rekka have switched up the setup. I like what Rekka did, the initial switch up early on, heavy mid presence, no one in long, and then mid round, the immediately deployed guy over in long. Bender should be careful, taking the fight with Dobu, and Dobu, he doesn't miss those shots with AK of his. 4v3 now, advantage as Mara finds Frostmourne. This is such good play from Mongols, and Rekka lost. They have absolutely no clue what Mongols are doing, and Mara, with that kill, he knows there shouldn't be anyone in the B bomb set. Cabal waiting towards short right next to the smoke, trying to catch someone off guard, and he gets spotted out. The rounds of a few bullets, and he's going to make his escape. It's now a 4v2, and Rekka. Rossi does find Cabal, but they're getting hunted down right now. Dobu going for the taps. Almost gets a kill on assist, but he gets taken down. And Mara and Insel, they're going for the hunt because they know it's going to be the last round. They know Rekka have saved it two rounds in a row. It's going to be the third round trying to save here. And the money's not going to be that great because they keep forcing back into the next round. So NCL, Mara, they're going to go for the hunt. Seem to be having second thoughts about it. Just going to allow Rekka to hold on to this AK and M4. That means Rekka should be still able to have a decent buy going into the final round of the first half. The scores are tied right now, 7-7. A little lucky. And Dobu, 16 kills. And you can see there, they've saved three rounds in a row right now. And the Mongols, of course, they have the money, the auto sniper, and the four ops. Why the hell not? And X-Crit, if he peeks mid, he's just going to get wrecked. But somehow manages to make his way through. How did none of them get tagged? And Dobu, going for the pre-fire, misses the shot. Mara, though, holding the line, finds one. Oh, what a shot from Mara to a coach! The coach is a beast! The B bomb site has been relinquished. Mara looking for more. Oh, this is the fast scope, though, as Bent is going to get the kill. Rozzy replies back as well, but Sogu's going to find Rozzy in the meantime, now with 3v2. And he's going to get spotted out. He gets a kill on the Cabal, but NCL's there for the trade. Immediate headshot assist. Bent left alone here, and he's going to get taken down. NCL with a double kill in the end. 8-7 to Mongols. They come out in the lead by just around in the very end. And that shot by Mara, the second one, was absolutely nasty. What? What was that? Best coach Asia, man. Best coach Asia. Around here, and you can see Mongols just a kit on Cabal. He's got a smoke as well. The rest of them with USBs and armor. And Rekka, they're trying to channel their inner Russian. Here comes the B push. Cabal trying to use the smoke to stay alive. And oh, what? What was they still don't know where he is? Mara's gonna get another killer of Frost Misty. How? What was that? Cabal, another kill, and NCL joins the party, picks up another final one, and what in the name of God was that? Holy Christ, Cabal, slow down there, son. And Rekka, okay, the normal speed replay, I guess. Just nasty, just absolutely freaking sick from Cabal. Just freaking nuts. And Rekka, they're gonna force it up. Tech-9s, CZ, P250. Not much of utility, however. Frost Misty, playing up closed doors. And Rozzy's already down to 1 HP. And they're doing a lot of damage. Rekka, the gathering up to go towards short, where they do have to contend with Tsugu's in a great position. All he has to do is stay over at Goose, because obviously when they push in, they're going to be pushing in towards trying to go for the short plant. And Seal's been blinded. Oh, nice shot there, DeRozzi, looking for more, gets another one, and Tsugu joins the party, goes for the spray, finds two, and Seal with the triple kill, a complete, absolute shutdown. EU observing, by the way, and that's going to be 10-7. And Mongols shutting it down perfectly, not losing a single man as well. And that's a scary thing about Mongols. Everyone stepping up. Cabal, Dobu, then we have Mara, Enseal, and Sogu as well, crucial kills, and Rekka. Full eco, 1 P250 being invested in, and making a lot of noise over in tunnels, so the Mongols should know this. And here they come charging out mid, though. Enseal's waiting with the scout, misses the shot, going for the running shot, they're just barreling into the double doors, a perfect Molotov, and they're getting fried alive. Never mind, they're going to get mowed down alive. As Mara, Cabal, Enseal, and Sugo pick up a frag apiece, and Enseal picks up the double, denying the team ace. But that is going to be Mongols winning two rounds in a row. Two rounds without losing a single man. And that is absolutely huge for their economy. Enseal's still going to be wielding the scout. They still will have the UMPs, of course. They're from Mars still. So the money's looking very solid right now. Mara will, however, upgrade to the AWP. And why not? He's hitting shots that are just out of this world right now. To bear in mind, it's a best of three. It's the first quarterfinals of the day, and this is of course Mongols' map pick. The second map is going to be Mirage, and that is a pick from Rekka. I'm looking to see what they have in store for us here. But right now, the scores are 7-11. Mongols still retaining the weapons from the previous round. No AWP on Rekka, though they have a scout and Excurate, and Mara is going to find Frost Misty with the AWP over at mid, and NCL waiting with the scout. Dobu pushing along. Oh, that UMP could just shred Excurate unless he pulls off some nutty Nico-like shot. NCL spots the flashes and the smoke's raining in from NCL. He's going to do a smart thing. He's going to fall back towards towards long. Sugu's been smoked off. And this is such a perfect flashbang, though. This is such a beautiful execution from Rekka. But oh, Rozzy looks the wrong way. And Dobu shuts out Excurate on the low. Sugu just shutting everything down. Bented lone man standing in the 1v5. He makes it a 1v4. But the bomb is dropped in no man's land. He gets tagged on by the scout from all the way from long platform by NCL. Dobu's going in for the hunt. And he's going to get the kill. And the Mongols, despite such a pretty nice execute from Rekka, they get wrecked. 12-7 for the Mongols, and we see the auto sniper out, the Dak out in Cabal. And wait, what? All right, the Dak's out. And I wonder where he's going to play with the auto sniper. We do have attack balls getting called by Rekka. Money's not that great. We'll be going for an eco. Might be seeing, might be seeing a little bit of some upgraded pistols coming out, perhaps. Should be 13-7 to Mongols right now. Rekka, though, yet to win any round on the T side. It's still, although it's been still early. They just lost their first buy round. They still have an opportunity to try and crawl back into this game. It's a T side. It is something where, you know, looking at aggression being showcased by Excurate and Benton, I mean, this is something that the T side should be something which they should be really comfortable with, which should be favoring them. But right now, haven't seen much yet. It's just been the Mongols just shutting things down all across the map. NCL and Dobu and 9K. They got the auto sniper and the AK out on both of them. And yeah, the money's looking good for a couple of these players. The rest of them, an average about $4,000. So you really should be worried about money at this particular point. As Rekka. Tech 9s, a couple of P250s, a Glock, a couple of flashes and a smoke. That's all the investment they have for this round. And right now, they just be looking to get the bomb down. Excurate. Cabal's alone. But Mara has the upper. Perfect flashbang. That is so absolutely perfect. Mara makes his way to safety. Don't miss the shot. He's going to peek around the corner. Oh, misses the shot. He's going to find him. It's all going to come down to Cabal, who finds one. Goes for the spray. Gets the second kill. Enseal helps him out. He's finding Sis in the meantime. Frosty, however, does get the kill, though. And Benton with a perfect flag. He glocks Enseal. And they get the bomb down. All of a sudden, it's a 2v2. Dobu, though, he knows where Benton is. And Benton's playing it very smart. He knows he's kind of trapped. And all he has to do is just stay alive. Stay alive for as long as he can and try to delay them. Try to delay the retake. And he's going to drop in. Oh! Lands a bullet on Sugu, but unable to get the kill. And now it's all done to Frost Misty. He's got an AK. No armor, no utility, nothing. And Mongols, one flash, two flashbangs, still have a flash in Dobu and a smoke. They just need to figure out where Frostmisty is playing from. Frostmisty hears him coming out from window. Here's both of them coming in from window. And they're going to be just sticking this out. Oh, and he gets the kill. And he spots the second guy as well. Oh, doesn't get the kill in the end. Soko will clutch it out. But that was very close indeed. A valiant effort from Frostmisty and Rekka on pretty much a full eco. Oh, they don't have the time. I thought he had it. Didn't have the time. And Rekka, they win it. They just win it. They pull it off. They pull it out from their backsides. That's a round that should have never have been won by Rekka. But somehow, I don't know how, but somehow they pull it off. And they win a round. They had absolutely no business winning. I knew it was going to be close, but I really thought he had it. But they just took forever just because Bented was staying alive for so very long over in short. And Rek Mongols are going to be kicking themselves in the butt over this. They're going to be really, really pissed off. They're going to be really pissed off. Oh, man. Mara, though. The aggression. Nasty flick shot. Falls back. No trades happening. And he's still going to hold the line. Is an NCL as well. And the flashbang comes in. Benson's not blinded. He gets taken up by Benton, however. Mara will make his escape. So the 4v4. And Rekka gathering their forces back towards mid. They're not it's a lot of time to work with. They don't really have to commit quite yet. And Mara playing from Goose. Dobu, meanwhile, just lurking long all on his own. Mara with the op, just holding from Goose. This is a very it's a 2-2 split for the CTs. They can get swamped. They can get overrun. Unless Rekka takes down Rekka, coming out for the mid to be played. Zogu, he's spotting from window. He's got the M4 out. And he spots the first guy. He's going to go for the fight. No, he's not. He's just going to play it safe. They need to decide. Either push out doors. Oh, the nade comes in. It takes a lot of damage. They're going to light up, but he still gets taken down. Kabal gets swamped as well by Benten. Mara just reply back, gets a kill onto Frostmisty. But now it's a 3v2. Barely, though. Benten is internally hemorrhaging at the moment. He's on 3 HP. And Dobu and Mara going in for the retake. They got a kit on Mara. They got a nade and a flashbang on Dobu as well as. And he is, well, it's going to be the save. Yep, it's going to be the save. Dobu just looking for the exits. And you can see Mara with the op. He doesn't want to give that one up. Because if they lose these two rifles, it's going to be a full eco for the Mongols. But Rekka, they're going to make it 9-12. And a triple kill for Bented, living up to his name. Oh, okay then. All right then. That was 1-6 spray transfer. Sis will, however, get the final kill. But Dobu should be pretty happy with the fact that it inflicted that much damage. But Rekka will be able to buy in pretty comfortably. And this spray transfer was just sweet sex. Absolutely brilliant. And for Mongols, they're going to, of course, buy in. For Mars, a couple of M4s, the UMP they have. A decent sum of utility as well, and that AWP on Mara has got to go to work here. And he's been doing very good work with it as well, you know, that aggressive short AWPing and just trying to go for the picks. And he needs to do that right now. They can't afford to play passively. They can't afford for Rekka to go for these executes and execute it. Takes a little bit of a tickle from the UMP. There's Mara towards short. Oh, nasty shot on Sis. And that's what I'm talking about. Mara, he has that AWP. He needs to take advantage of that. And execute it, though. Mongol to set up a nice crossfire. Zogu. Nice smoke. And Kabal uses that perfectly. Continues to spray and almost finds a good Frostmisty. Does reply back. 7 HP or not. He gets a kill onto Zogu. But Kabal's still there. Picks up 2 quick kills. Kabal is coming. Going huge here. Picks up a triple kill with the UMP. The bomb is dropped out in no man's land. Razu is all alone in a 1v4. And Kabal has pretty much secured the round for his team single-handedly. And it's going to be 9-13. And for Rekka, they have to eco now. And Mara won't miss that shot. 13-9. And this is just the hero play from Kabal. UMP, close range, completely decimates that push by Rekka. The second he saw the smoke, I guess they were trying to trade for Excurate, but honestly, they could have played a little bit more slower there. Nine and 13, Rekka. With the pretty much full eagle, Tech 9, Peter 50 Deagle. A flash. And a smoke. The only investment. Perfect flashbang. Dogo finds Bentet. And he's gonna fall back. Using the range to their advantage. They got the rifle. They don't even need to go for the close fight. As Rekka are falling back from long. They haven't made a presence felt. But just a one smoke. Just a one smoke to work with. They need to at least get a pick if they... Imagine... You know, a hope of winning this round. But... again, Mongols. Not much presence over mid. Dobo's over in short. He can drop down immediately if required, but he's going to be seeing a lot of action real quickly over in short. But he's got his teammate backing him up as well. It's going to be so good. First shot. Flashbang comes out, and Dobo joins a party. Picks up two quick headshots for himself, and it's going to be a very easy shutdown. Razu with the Glock. Doing a bit of damage. NCL taking a while to get that kill, but that is going to be round number 14 for the Mongols. And two rounds away from taking map number one. And once again, Dobu and Sogu with the beautiful shutdown. Eco-frags. Frag to frag. As a Rekka, they will of course have to buy into this round. The Galil and Razu utility, pretty sparse. Excurate trying to get the jump scout going, but they push into lower tunnels. I don't think he spotted them out. He hasn't spotted them. Frost Misty is going to get taken down. He does barely any damage either. And Mara, with that angle, this is so good for Mongols. He doesn't have to worry about lower tunnels. He's got his teammates. They have complete control of tunnels. And that means they should know that it's going to be most probably a long play coming out here. Look at Sogu. He's not stopping. Hold W. Don't stop. That is such a typical Mongolian thing to do. Sis, however, is very much aware of how Mongolians like to play as well. He's going to get killed on Sogu, but Dobu drops the bomb. He goes for the trade. Excrete with the scout. And here's the thing, right? They just forget that the S button exists. They just keep pushing in. They keep pushing in. Dobu using, they're trying to use that smoke against Rekka. He's gonna spot out Bented, but Bented, Excurate only team up together to get the kill, but NCL almost gets the kill onto Excurate. Now it's a 3v3, Excurate internally bleeding, Mara with the op waiting over at long doors. So he thought it was a flash, he actually falls back because of it. The Molotov's gonna come in, it might be a little bit too late, they'll get spotted out. The Nate's gonna do a bit of damage as well, and he's gonna miss the shot. Roz is gonna take him down, being a little bit too ultra-aggressive was Mara. Now it's a 2v3, bomb, still to get planted, NCL with the flashbang, and bomb still not down. The Molotov preventing the plan from taking place. And another Molotov. They're delaying this plan for as long as possible. They try to get control of the A bomb site. Cabal's pushed in, but he's all alone now, stuck in Gandalf. And I think he got spotted out. Yes, no, maybe not. But Bented is there to decapitate him. Round number 10 for Rekka. As they hold on, and the Mongols will, of course, be able to buy again. And just this, I think that's been the big mistake for both the teams, is how they just have this unbridled aggression. They just don't know when to say, all right, we've done enough, let's go back. And just keep pushing, just keep pushing. And Excrete was guilty of that earlier. Rekka was kind of guilty of that in the CD side, in Mongols as well. That round could have definitely easily gone the way of Mongols. That complete control. But they pushed up top mid. And even Mara from the A-side boxes. I don't know why he remained there for so long. I mean, again, jumping on top of the boxes when he saw the flashes and nades raining in. It should have been kind of given that it was going to be a fast, long play. And he's been pretty much on point, though. So really can't find much fault in Mara. He's been definitely on point this entire game. 10 to 14 right now. Rekka. The paw flash over in mid. And Cabal doing his best Mario impression. Trying to spot someone out over at mid. And Molotov's gonna come in, gonna push him back. Immediate counter flash coming in from the CT. And that's a nice counter flash, but he's not gonna take advantage of that. He's actually gonna hold on to his Molotov. Bentet's gonna find Sogu. Dobu replies by finding Razu in the meantime, and Does Cabal know where the man is? He can't see him through the flames. The bomb is dropped out in the open as well. And this is looking, this is a pretty rough Mexican standoff. Extra is going to find Dobu in the meantime. Oh, Cabal comes pushing out, and Mara, he's got to go big here. He finds one, needs to go for more. Extra with a nasty flick shot. Mara's going to get a double kill, but they picked up the bomb. And they're making their way towards the A bomb, so Mara's going to go for the clutch here. This is going to be very hard indeed, but Benton Extra both very low. And Mara swaps over immediately, and Extra with a nasty shot. He legs Mara, and he knows he's very low indeed. The nade comes in a little too late, of 8 HP, and he still gets the kill, but Benton will trade, and that's going to be round number 11, I'm sorry, for Rekka. Again, coming down to 1v1. And Mara, my god, making it very scary again for Rekka. 14-11, Mongols will finally go for an eco. Something which you rarely see. I'm a little surprised Cabal pushed out long without a smoke. And Excrit, here's a lot of Mongol members towards long, and they're going to immediately fall back. It's a full long stack, and they're pushing into tunnels as well. Cabal pushing into upper dark, and he's getting some information. That's Excrit. This is the shot, gets taken down. That's the op taken out, but Benton's holding the line. Finds one, finds two. Actually, he's going to Frostmissy, gets a kill. Cabal hasn't spotted out. Now Frostmissy will nade NCL, and Frostmissy picking up another kill, picks up a triple kill, and it's all down to Dobu, who has managed to pick up the AWP. And of course, ends up. That's smart. That's very smart from Dobu. If you can win the round, make them bleed. Nice flashback. It's Sis coming in with a flank from T spawn. 12 to 14. Rekka. Yeah, that op being tossed away means Sis can still buy an op for Excurit, though. Yes, he will. He will drop the op to Excurit. So they do keep the op in play. Mara, glass cannon. This is a pretty tight game here, Mongols. They're unable to close it out. Fast B play. This actually might work out. Mara routes off a bullet too earlier, but misses the second shot as well. It needs to find at least one, but an aim punch is going to kick, and he gets taken down now. And a B bomb site has been compromised. They have the smoke. Smoke's going to blue. Molotov comes out. And Mongols, you can already see it's going to be a save here. Early save call. They don't want to go for this. 5v4. They're just going to hold onto the rifles and play for the next round here. It's going to be 13 to 14. Very fast round for Rekka. I loved it. I absolutely loved it. Just changing the gears, changing things up, and just rushing B. And sometimes, rush B, don't stop, works perfectly. And for the Mongols, I'm not sure. I think they've lost three rounds now. I think they just opened up tab for a second there. There we go. Yeah, they lost four rounds in a row right now, so that means they will be able to, yeah, they will have enough money to go for the buy here. At least someone to drop. Although it'll have to be probably a FAMAS. Or a scout, yeah. Go for the range battle, try your luck with a scout against Excurit. And rest of they're going to be able to buy. Even if they lose this round, it will be max loss bonus, but they wouldn't want to lose this round because the money's not that great. If they lose this round, it's going to be 14 all, and it's going to be max loss bonus, but most of them are below $1,000 right now, so that means they're going to have about $4,000 on average on almost all of them, which means just rifles and armor and barely any utility. And that could give Rekka the opportunity to make it to map point, which is something the Mongols really wouldn't be looking forward to. It is their map pick. Bear that in mind, ladies and gentlemen. Mongols pick Dust 2, and Rekka are making a game of it right now. NCL just has a scout. You can see Rekka. They're feeling it out. They're just trying to feel out the map, trying to find out what's happening. Where are Mongols playing from? It's the Mongols. They don't play static. That's one thing I like about the Mongol CD side. Although I do keep complaining over the fact that they keep pushing unnecessarily a little too much, yet I still love the fact that their CD side is so dynamic. You can't expect them to go for, you know, just the same set CD side hold like many Asian teams do. Xcrit with the op meme all over the long. It's going to be a lot of presence from Rekka though, but attack comes in onto Razu and Zogu. He just shoots. He's gonna find one. Trace through the smoke, looking for more, but Sis gonna get burnt alive. And this is just complete utter chaos. Domu's gonna find Frostmist in the meantime. Xcrit with the op, replies back, finds one. Needs to stay alive here. And he's got his op trained, and Benton's gonna get a kill out of Domu. Benton with a double kill. Benton with a hero plays once more. Cabal coming in from short. They need to get the bomb down here. 20 seconds on the clock, and the bomb will get planted for long. And Benton, 12 HP, perfect flashbang, and he's go. It's taken down by Cabal, who's under 19 HP, and Xcrit is holding the line with the AWP. Cabal's got to get the kill here, and he's going for some brief fire, and Xcrit gets taken down. Cabal's going to win the round, and Xcrit, oh my god, that, despite the heroics of Bentet, and the bomb wasn't really planted for Xcrit, he had to go for that, for that hold. Unfortunate for him, but the Mongols, Cabal, with the 1v2 in the end, we have a technical pause getting called as we seem Xcrit seems to have dropped out of the server. So Rekka, they have all the money in the world to go for the buy for the last two rounds, but can they win the round is a question. Mongols are on map point, and Rekka need to win two rounds in a row to take it to overtime. And what a round that was. Bent it, almost pulled it off, and man, Cabal. Bent it with a perfect flash as well. Cabal was completely blinded, yet gets the kill, and then Xcrit misses a shot. Like, he's been hitting almost every shot this entire game, and that one shot he really needed to land. Whips it. But then, such is life, such is Counter-Strike. Deep shit. 15-13, Mongols. Mara with the AWP. Can they close it out is the question. Xcrit gets spotted out. And he just spots one guy going B. Dino goes with a shot, misses it. And of course that's Mara. And for the Mongols. I really do enjoy watching the Mongol CD side, I'll be honest. There's so much variation. It's like the Kama Sutra. Compared to the missionary, which most Asian teams perform on the CD side, the same thing over and over and over and over and over again. Mongols, though, just mixing things up. They're trying different setups every single time, aggressing, catching people off guard. NA flash, or rather, it's an Asian flash. Slowly walking out mid. There is a guy boosting the box. It's Zogu. But he has no eyes. And now, sits up, finds a kill, but Xcrit will decapitate him. Now it's a 4v4. There's still two guys in the B-bomb side. Xcrit, another kill. He's just shutting it down, catching all the CDs on a rotate. And they still haven't made a play yet. This is so smart. This is so smart from Rekka. Benton has made his way all the way over to the A-bomb side. And Mongols won't be expecting this. They won't be expecting it. They saw the mid to be play, and both the guys are trapped inside a side. Cabal peeking around the corner, and Sis is waiting for him. This is just genius play from Rekka. Dobu's walked in all the way over towards the long doors, and he hears a C4 running, but he can't run, because the second he runs, they're going to be aware of it. And it's all alone now, 1v4, and Rekka have completely dissected the Mongols' defense. Xcrit with the triple kill. Rekka are one round away from taking it to overtime, ladies and gentlemen. That was just pristine play. Completely, utterly outplayed. Just beautiful play from Rekka. Last round of regulation time. Auto sniper on Bentet. And spare a thought, a prayer, a small little prayer for Mongols. They're broke. I just smell overtime coming right now. Next year it finds Mara as well. And they have pushed into mid, but the B-bomb side has been completely compromised. Xcrit, he can do whatever he wants right now, I mean. And he's doing a smart thing, looking towards upper tunnels. And Seal's gonna fall. Ladies and gentlemen, it's gonna be overtime. The scores are tied. Rekka with a massive, massive comeback. This has been just absolutely insane stuff from the Nation team. This is a very far cry from NXL. This is a team whose potential has been realized. That's all I can say. They are playing out of their minds right now. Everyone. Bentet, Sis, 21 frags, 22 on X-Grid. Frost Misty in 15. Rossi kind of quiet, but that's okay. But the rest of the team are performing so well. That's all right. 27 on Dobu, 24 kills on Cabal. Mara on 20, 18 on Sogo. It's like everyone's doing what they can here on both sides. Mongols, it is MR6 rule set. Three rounds for both the teams on either side. And 10k money. Mara trying to do JW things. Next year's going to be tagged on 21 HP, and Mara with the aggro angle here. They're going to double peek. Ooh, the timing, Mara. That flashbang just deviated his attention for that one second that X-Grid needed to get into a more advantageous position. Horrendous timing for Mara. Cabal trying to push in through the flames. And X-Grid's waiting. He's waiting. Spot the shoulder. What a shot! This guy is just an absolute beast. Why did it take them so long to get him on a roster? X-Grid is just a freaking god right now. And you have Bentet. So, yeah, this is looking a little hairy for Mongols. They're going to save the rifles. Because here's the thing with MR6 rule sets, right? If you lose your, especially on the CD side, if you lose your first two rounds, you will have Jack to work with in the final round. You will barely have any money. You'll just have to make do with CZs, maybe a Deagle, maybe a UMP in the mix. That's about it. So, smart call from Mongols to go for the save early on. And NCL and Dobu. Oh boy. Fresh Kebab over at Long. Dobu, last one remaining. He needs to stay alive. But they're gathering up together. Dobu needs to get the kill here. Finds one. Should get the second kill as well. Bentet, but he misses it. And Bentet's going to get the headshot. And that's going to be 16 to 15. Rekka winning the first round in overtime. And the Mongols, they lose every gun. Now, this spy, they need to win this spy or else the money is going to be an absolute... it's just going to be wrecked, completely wrecked if they lose this round for the Mongols. Wreck up, 16-15. What a comeback, though. What a comeback for Wreck up, from Wreck up. For a new team. I mean, sure, like four of these guys have been playing together for a long, long time. But still, I mean, it's pretty much a new team. And showing the level of tenacity that you don't even see in some of the more older, more better known Asian teams. This is just some very impressive stuff. Especially against the Mongols. And I honestly believe, like, I didn't really buy the hype. Because I'm like, yeah, they won against, like, lesser teams. But right now, the way they're playing, I gotta say, I mean, welcome to the top 10 club, boys. These guys are looking very solid. Still early. Still 16. They're in the lead, but still a number of rounds to go. But the way they're playing right now, they're playing better than most teams in Asia. Frost Misty walks out. Sogu looking for more. Gets the dink, but X-Grid will get the frag. 4v3. X-Grid down to 9 HP. Rekka once more with a man advantage. And Cabal, he needs to make some movie. But X-Grid, again, this guy is so good. So good with the lurk. He's holding the line there, and he knows even if they come in through tunnels, he's holding the line here, and he might get taken out by Cabal, though. Oh, what a shot! This guy is a madman! How did he land that shot? 9 HP. He wasn't just holding the angle either. He walked in. He walked into Cabal's, Cabal's crosshair, and I'm losing my voice talking about this guy. It's got to be 17 to 15, ladies and gentlemen. And Mongols, your money is shredded. Rosu, oh, with the aggression, goes for the spray. And NCL with the team kill as well. Things are falling apart for the Mongols. Holy Christ. Okay, that is so sick. And Rosu, helped out by NCL. 70-15. Mongols are broke. They are broke. This is, yeah, that's like pretty much the Somali economy right now. Rekka, three auto snipers, two ops. Why the hell not? Frost Misty. They definitely have the weaponry advantage. And taking very slow, though. And this is going to give Cabal the opportunity to creep all the way over to T-spawn. Where the bomb is with Excurate. With the AWP. And there are a lot of guns lying around there. There are two auto snipers lying around. And, oh. Excurate. Oh no, the bomb's down! The bomb's down, and Cabal has his hands on the AWP and an auto sniper, two auto snipers, whatever he wants. He's got armor as well. Frost Misty, meanwhile, is going to pick up two quick kills. Marara and NCL taken down, but the bomb is down, and that's going to be a problem. I like what Wrecker's doing, though. They're first trying to get the remaining players, and then. Ooh, Cabal narrowly misses the shot. Sis finds Sogu, but Rozu coming in from T spawn finds Cabal, and it's all down to Dobu, the Deagle, and the prayer. He knows that the bomb is a T-spawn. It's not going to bother going there. Just trying to clear out mid, trying to find a kill in between, but it's going to be the bomb getting planted. It's making its way towards B, and Dobu is a little too late to the party. Frost Misty, I think he spotted out Dobu there over in mid. And you can see, yep, immediate smokes towards B tunnels. 10 seconds on the clock. They will get the bomb down, and Dobu, well, nothing much you can do here. It's going to be 18-15. Rekka. One round away after this. One round away from taking map number one, Mongols map pick. This has just been a masterclass performance from. Oh, Dobu, what? Almost gets a triple kill there. Bented, though, with perfect flank. Crazy work from Dobu. If he had got a third kill, I would have soiled my pants. But Rekka Esports win all three rounds. And they need one more round. Mongols. Oh, not like this. Not like this. The AWP and Mara. Bent to the next year, the double AWP setup. Bots out Cabal, gets the kill. The aggression over in short. And Mongols, they need to win three in a row here to get overtime number two, or else it's going to be map one going the way of Rekka, and that's something which is just horrible. Like, something they really would be hurting over. It's their map pick. Next one's going to be Mirage, which is the map pick coming in from Rekka. Rekka on the brink of pulling up a pretty big upset. Although it's still map one, still got two more maps to go. Deep Molotov Dobu. Able to aggress in. And this is so smart from Rozu. This is so smart. Using that Molotov to his advantage. He's going to push in. Oh, he spots a shadow as well. Finds one. Goes for the spray. Unable to get a second kill as Dobu will get taken down. But Sis is waiting for him. But Dobu with a running headshot instantly decapitates Sis. 3v3 now. But Bented is waiting with it. Oh, he spots a shoulder of Dobu. Flashbang comes out. And he's getting trapped from all corners here. But Bented with a great shot on Mara. Looking for more spots on Dobu as well. Goes for the second kill through the flashbang. He's looking for the final kill. And it's got to be Bented to close it out, ladies and gentlemen.